What's up, Fitted Squad? This is Brad, aka Too Fitted, coming to you with another quick video. And today, as you can see, we are getting a late start to today's video. Basically, tonight's video. But the reason for that is because I've had quite a few people hit me up asking me about the lighting mods that I have on the car. They wanted to know more about like the underglow, headliner, and the trunk and stuff like that. So figured I'd let it get a little dark, that way I can kind of show it off. Had some people asking about the headlights as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and go over all the lighting mods that I currently have and a few things about kind of about what I would like to add or change on what I have as well. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into it. So I figured what I would do is start with the daytime running lights. I do have the 2017 Midnight Edition, and that came with the LED package. I know the 2018s didn't come with that, but that was something we did get it with the 2017. I think the 2017.5s didn't even get that. So, and for you, those of you who don't know, that's that. So either you have it or you don't. You need to get the whole housing if you don't have it. And while I'm out here, I will show this. I did do the LED tag light upgrade. This one was just a cheap one. I think it was from eBay or Amazon or something, so not exactly sure where I got that from. But also, here we go for the trunk. These are LED strips, and I can change the color on that. Just have to get into the app. I do have a remote for it, but the remote has not really worked too well. I'll have a link in the description below for most of the things that I could talk about. The things from eBay or the little things like the tag light, I won't really go over. I won't have a link for that because, you know, I don't really know where those are from or which ones they were, I should say. And I have some lights on the floor as well. Turn that off. I did not do the upgrade on the interior, but let's see when the light turns off. A lot of people asking about this. Sorry, the mic was facing away from me, but I haven't changed the light color in so long, but we can definitely change to a bunch of different ones. But I mean, we got different patterns too. I usually keep it on the white. This is more of a flashing. This is a fade effect. But yeah, I usually keep it on the white. But I mean, I could definitely do any of them that I would like there. But this is one of the whites. This is supposed to be like a more natural one. And then this is just like a real white. Sometimes I'll go back and forth between them, but 9 times out of 10 I keep it on this one. But this one is definitely brighter. I'll probably keep it here anyway. Now I did not install that myself. The homie Ryan installed, actually he installed pretty much all the lights here. I think the only thing he didn't do, of course, would be the headlights. Oh yeah, speaking of, I did upgrade the fog lights. So, I gotta turn the car on for that. As I just had the the aux running. But yeah, let's take a look at this, because this makes a big difference. Because even with the LED package, I still had just the halogen fog lights. So that was pretty trash. Didn't make sense to me anyway, but these are from Last Fit. So I don't ever really use, well, I won't say ever, but I don't have to use the, oh, I gotta replace that. I have the replacement upstairs. So yeah, not even sure what happened to that one, honestly. But I didn't realize it was so dim, messed up like that. But I do have the replacement upstairs. You see the difference. But yeah, like I was saying, I don't really use the high beams unless I'm like on a backcountry road or something like that, which I'm hardly ever at. And this remote that I have is not working. Let me see. Yeah. So I gotta check out this remote. I thought this was the one for the trunk. It should be. But it's not working, so throw that in there. But let me go ahead and turn on the underglow. It's been a little minute since I really done much with that. I'm on the switch. So that turns on the underglow. This is just the my usual riding color. So connecting to the phone right now. Jeez, a lot of my neighbors got stuff that's on this network, because I'm seeing everybody's stuff on here. Alright, I do have a link to the underglow as well as the headliner in a description below, which is in the description of all of my videos. This is a good demo mode for it, really, because it really just shows you how much it kind of chases there. But yeah, I really need to get that replaced. Not looking good at all. But yeah, that's kind of pretty much it for the upgrades that I have for lighting. I do have some LED bulbs for the tail light, but I have not installed those yet. Those are from Last Fit as well. So I'll definitely get those installed here eventually. Maybe when we fix that, replace that. I honestly keep forgetting about it, because 9 times out of 10 when I am driving, I'm not really out at night, which is also why I forgot about that switch for a little bit. But yeah, definitely let me know what you guys think. I know when I first put the underglow on, I did have some people talk about, oh, that's so racy and this and that, but honestly, I can turn it off at any time. But also, I mean, it's not like it's always a persistent thing anyway. But it grew on me. I like it a lot. And that's the wave down here anyway. So, yeah. But like I said, I usually stick to white. Every now and then, I might do purple or blue. Sometimes I might do this one, but 9 times out of 10, this is what I'm rocking with. And if I'm like at a meet or something, I might run this one or this one or even this one. But yeah, before we go ahead and end this video, before we end it, I'd like to thank you for all who have been hitting me up with the questions. If you got any video ideas or questions like that, feel free to hit me up, leave a comment down below, or hit me up on Instagram. If you see me on Facebook, you can hit me up there too. But Instagram is probably the easiest way to reach me if it's not on YouTube. So, yeah, and the comment of the day goes out to... And if you'd like to be selected for comment of the day, make sure you leave a comment down below. And who knows, you could be next. But I'd like to thank you all for tuning in. Please like, comment, subscribe, and as always, stay fitted. Peace.